Welcome to video number 51 on working with train controller. In version 9 there are a couple of new switchboard items available, like a space-saving crossover and also fully automated working gates. Let's have a look how we can use those. If you have a crossing between two tracks, then in previous versions, if you would like to use a real cross in the middle, it took you 9 grid blocks. You could leave out the official cross and just use 4 junctions. That works perfectly well. But in the new version 9, there's a new item available, and that is the space-saving crossover. Let's have a look where we can find it on the track ribbon, and then over here the crossover. If I would place them over here, we would see they look like this. And well, that's a real space saver because it takes only 2 grid blocks. If your switchboard starts to become a bit cramped, this can be the way to go. Obviously, one element has now 2 junctions inside, so there are 2 addresses that you can put in here for your decoder. That's nice that this is available, but even nicer maybe are 2 automated new items called gates, and they can be found in the accessory tab. One of them is the gate that looks like this, and let me place 2 of those over here. This is going to be our garage or tool shed, and well, to make that a little bit more appealing to the eye, what I could do is place a text block over it, or rather behind it. Let me first place a space to get rid of the question mark it otherwise places. It's a background. I want a frame of black color, and the color itself is gray. And there I have my shed. At least if I enlarge it a bit. Yeah, that looks good. This is how you can simulate that there is a building somewhere or whatever. Now let's have a look at the gate. It is also equipped with an address. So you can use, let's say, a servo decoder to open your garage doors. It, like any element, it can be controlled by other elements that have an operations tab. But this one also works fully automatic. As soon as this route becomes active, the door will automatically close. Well, let's just try that out. Let me place a train over here and start the simulator, and then auto train that guy to my garage. And look what happens. If the track is active, the door closes automatically, so my servo is now slowly opening those doors. And as soon as my engine is in the shed and the route is deactivated again, then my door will automatically close. If you don't want that, you can use conditions or other things to control it in a different way, but this is helpful that it is also fully automatic. Maybe when you are inside the garage and you want to drive out, it depends on how fast the doors open. You don't want to bump into a half opened door, so maybe best put a delay in this block, a delay after a green signal, or a delay specific for this block, which you can put in the block properties of a schedule. Another gate is the road crossing gate, also to be found with the accessories. This one, it is a crossing gate, and let's just place a couple. Let me place one over here on the single track and a second one on the other single track. But you can also use one gate over multiple tracks. The way to do that is by simply dragging it over all the tracks. Now it has one decoder address, and it is automatically being switched whenever both one of the routes is active, and it opens again if both routes are not active. So that is also fully automatic. Let's just have some fun and see that working in reality. I'm going to have an auto train of this guy over here. Okay, go on the run for me. I should of course start the simulator. We see now already that this single gate is closed and the double gate is also closed, and this one is still open. I'm going to put the other train on an auto train now too, and let's have a look from here to there. Yeah, there we go. Obviously now all gates are closed, and let's now see what happens as soon as one or two of the tracks become free again. Obviously this bottom engine is a little bit of the slow type. Yeah, there it is. The double gate is still closed, but the single gate is open. Yeah, and now all the gates are opened again. We see that this works fully automatic. I don't have to do anything about it. It is controlling the decoder, the servo, probably servo decoder, fully automatically. If you want it differently, you can use conditions and push buttons and what have you. Well, this was it for this video. Thank you for watching, and maybe see you back in a future video.